thank you very much. I'm glad to take part to in so beautiful conference and so beautiful place, and I am very appreciate organizers that invite me to do some talk here. Mm-hmm. Then I start from blackboard, but after that I show some slides with photo, and you will see our heroes, yes, from dynamical system. And then I will say about Morse-Smale system. Morse-Smale. F, I denote it by F, on arbitrary closed manifold, given on closed manifold in any dimension. But the most part will be devoted to surfaces, but I start for any closed manifold. And then what is mean Morse-Smale system? Now modern definition, the simplest definition, that is structural stable system whose non-wandering set, non-wandering or alpha omega limit set or chain recurrent set, it doesn't matter, whose non-wandering set, it's equivalent for hyperbolicity, non-wandering set consists of finite number orbits. Orbits or trajectories, it's the same for me because I will consider also continuous system or discrete dynamical system. It doesn't matter for me. And then, indeed, it's very simplest structural stable system. And then I will interest in topological equivalent of this system. What does it mean? It means that we will consider two types of system. One type is flow. It means that time belongs to R, it's flow. And I will denote it by Ft. And I will consider also discrete dynamical system, Ft, where T belongs to Z. And I will denote, it is in Russian literature is cascade, but I know that it's not popular, and more popular definition diffeomorphism, and then I will denote it by F. And then we know for such diffeomorphism, non-wandering set consists of finite number orbits, and then what is mean topological conjugacy? Topological conjugacy or equivalence if the same. Two system, FT prime, are topologically equivalent, if there is gamiomorphism. Gamiomorphism from ambient manifold, who send orbits of one system to the orbits of other. Who sends orbits to orbits. It's absolutely the same for discrete dynamical systems. Then I can write F here, F prime here, and then it will be the same. But definition for this notion is not topological equivalent, topological conjugacy. But other is the same. And then this topological conjugacy for this diffeomorphism, it's possible to reduce to some property. It means that H has such property, for example, this. And then we know that our conjugacy, we're interested. What it's enough to know about diffeomorphism, then we can say that it's absolutely exactly belongs to one topological class. Mm-hmm. And then it means that we find topological invariant. And then this topological invariance possible to be very different, combinatorial, topological, and moduli, continuous invariant, and other. But we're interested in what's enough for very simple system, which we call a Morse-Smale system. And then I have to start by history, and I think that we agree with me that this system was born in 1937 year, because in that year was published paper of Alexander Andronov, who works in Nizhny Novgorod, in my city, and organized some team who investigate dynamical system of different dynamical system. Andronov was physicist, and then interested in radio wave and some effects in radio, indeed, and not in pure mathematics. But this paper have two authors. It's Andronov and Lev Pontryagin. Pontryagin was Moscow mathematician, not from Nizhny Novgorod, from Moscow. And then what wrote in this paper? From Nizhny Novgorod, Gorky, former Gorky, now is Nizhny Novgorod. I am also from Nizhny Novgorod, and school of Andronov indeed, because my advisor Greenis is pupil of not Andronov, but wife, his wife. But I will say about this because there is a very wide school on dynamical system, and then he considers such very simple system of differential equation, and maybe one. Andronov was first who introduced the notion structural stable for such differential equation, but in that time it was not notion, there is no notion structural stable, there is notion rough. And then this paper has name rough systems. And then what he mean when defined this roughness? It mean that if we such system one is rough, if we add some small additional here, some small perturbation here and here, then we will see that the system becomes topologically equivalent to initial system. And moreover, additional property that this conjugating homomorphism, which realizes equivalency, has to be close to identity. It's unique.
So the definition of equivalence and conjugacy, those were in place, and people use that.
Does what place?
They were in place. They existed. Mm-hmm. Andronov and Pontryagin were working with this definition.
This definition. This definition that equivalency, it means that there is homeomorphism which send trajectory to trajectory, but roughness, it means that there is some neighborhood of the system. It means that if we do small perturbation, then our system, new system, becomes stay to equivalent to initial. But he required that this homeomorphism which realize this equivalence is close to identity. It's unique difference from structural stable, if you know. Then he required this, and then it was definition of structural, of roughness for this system. And then he proved a few theorem. For example, theorem one says that necessary and sufficient condition for such system to be rough contains some conditions. For example, one is rough, this system is rough, if and only if, and after that will some list of properties, but it's not so long, and then I can write it. It means that non-wandering set of this system of one consists of finite number, no, finite finite orbits. Orbits is finite orbits, and this orbits is hyperbolic. It was first condition. No, what is mean? I guess that you know, but I repeat. It means that if it is a singular point, it means that this point is a sink like this. This sink is a source. Possible to have a recurrent trajectory different from periodic orbits. Then, after that stops because Meyer died, unfortunately, Andronov died, unfortunately, very soon. And then next step in this theory.
So they were well aware of Poincaré's work.
Poincaré?
Yeah.
Does this classification.
Meyer and Leontovich. So they were aware of Poincaré's work. They knew Poincaré.
Oh, I don't understand. New Poincaré?
Did they know about Poincaré's work? I mean, rotation number, Poincaré cross-section, and all that?
Yes. They know, of course.
They did not have to invent it themselves.
Yes, but I don't understand. Invented in himself?
So he's asking if they did this independently from what Poincaré did.
No, maybe Poincaré did complete classification of this, yes?
No, just asking if they knew about Poincaré.
I guess that in the school known Poincaré paper, I guess, because Leontovich known French language and can write indeed. And then in that time, our laboratory was very rich indeed and contains very rich library, and then next step in this direction was in 1959 only it's more later, and moreover the step was in Brazil, not in Nizhny Novgorod, Brazil, Maurizio Pichota, consider flow similar to Andronov-Pendragon flow on any surfaces, on any restriction, and then he put definition of not roughness, but appear structural stability for such flows, and then it's the same absolutely, but there is no requirement H is close to identity, but now it's known that it's equivalent notion, but it was different notion in that time, and then defined structural stability, but after that he proved theorem one. Necessary and sufficient condition. No, I clean, but I hope that you remember what this. It means that flows on the surface, on arbitrary surface, is rough, or structural stable, I'm sorry, structural stable, if and only if, and after that, least absolutely the same. This is finite number, hyperbolic, etc., but here it's transversal intersection. He changed, but it's absolutely the same for two-dimensional case. It also means that there is no saddle connection. After that, he proved theorem two, of course, that such system is dense on space of all flows on surfaces. And then, what about theorem three? Theorem three will more later. It was 1971, also Maurizio Pichota. And then what we prove, what he proved? He proved absolutely the same. Like to scheme for Leontovich and Meyer, this object division by cells has name His name is Schim. Schim of Leontovich Meyer. Schim Leontovich Meyer. Леонтович Майер. But Муриці Пішота, Схім of Леонтович Майер. But Пішота understood that it's possible to describe this list of cells by combinatorial. And then he introduced some directed graph for theorem 3 for classification. He introduced directed graph. What does it mean? For example, if we consider absolutely the same system, what we considered before, then he assigned for each singularity point, some vertex. For example, omega 1, omega 2, sigma and alpha, and after that, all separatrices corresponding to some edge of this graph. And then we get like this. And then we get new invariant, very combinatorial invariant, gamma FT. This is graph. Directed graph. It means that we have direction on this edge, like this. But it's not enough, of course, if two graphs absolutely the same, it's not mean that such system topologically equivalent. What's problem? Problem is absolutely the same. We have to describe all cells which contain this system. And then it appears some notion of subgraph of this system. For example, what is mean subgraph? For the system, subgraph is part of this graph which corresponds to boundary of cells. It means that we include this subgraph to this, we include this subgraph to this, and then was list of some subgraphs here. That's all, but it was also not very simple invariant. No, subgraph is very simple, but subgraphs, no, we have to check that for other system we have the same graph, we have to the same system of subgraph, and we have to check something. But it does not matter, it was very combinatorial invariant, and Pichota finished this topic for flows, for surfaces on surfaces. And but after that, approximately 1989, Pichota's paper contains some gap. And gap concerning this following situation. If you remember, Leontovich and Meyer choose in some cells some trajectory, one trajectory. Pichota did not do this. And gap was in exactly this place. Because if you consider some cells between two limit cycles, then you know that this trajectory in this integral can have such behavior, or can have like rib filiation behavior. And then if we don't require something, then graph is not complete invariant. And after that, Ashemkov and Charcot, it's more later, it's Andrei Ashemkov, and Vladimir Charcot. Ashemko from Moscow, Charcot from Kyiv, if I understand. And then they suggest very different invariant, not very different, but it's dual invariant for this graph. This graph has name three-colored graph. And then I can explain what they do because it's very useful for us. And for example, for this system, what they suggested. If you consider our system again, then we have to consider all cells of this flow, but Ashemkov and Charcot suggested to choose one trajectory. In the beginning, it means that here trajectory T1, here trajectory T2, and then divided our ambient manifold, not only stable and unstable separatrices, but divided it by this one trajectory, any trajectory in these cells. What sense of this? Because we will see that now we have some triangles. This is number of triangles. All part of this division is triangle. And this triangle very regular because each this triangle has one side which is unstable separatrice, one side which is stable separatrice, and exactly one side with this T curve. This is curve which is arbitrary trajectory. Very regular domains. There is no difference between one domain and other. And then if we consider here, for example, we see that here we have four triangles, and then we can assign for this division some graph. But graph, vertex of this graph corresponds to this domain, not for singular point, corresponds to domain. And then we get a graph with four vertex here, for example. And after that, if we see, we understand that from each vertex goes to exactly three edges corresponds to this boundary of this triangle. And then it's very regular object, is three-colored graph. And moreover, Pichotta didn't consider question about distinguishing this graph by algorithmic invariant. But Ashemkov and Charcot represent some algorithmic invariant because this graph is very regular. Indeed, and can be put on the same surface where there is some flow, and then they introduce some algorithmic invariant. But now we know that this algorithmic invariant is not so good because it's not effective. And then after that, we write some paper where suggest other invariant and then more effective, and distinguish two graph by polynomial time. Indifferent from here because it was only exponential time, but it does not matter. And then you see that now there is complete classification for Morse-Smale flow, and that's all. Then what next step? The next step is following. In 1961, it's step ago, Steve Smale wrote paper on Morse inequality. Yes, on Morse inequality. On Morse inequality. Inequality. No, it does not matter what name of this paper, but he suggested to consider flow on any closed manifold, flow on any closed in any dimension, like to Andronov with Andronov-Pontryagin property. Andronov-Pontryagin property. It means that finite number orbits in non-wandering set and transversal intersection. In high dimension, it's necessary to require transversal intersection. And then in this paper, he proved that for such system, is true some inequality, like to Morse inequality in topological sense. But after that, all this system has name Morse-Smale system. Not Andronov-Pontryagin, Morse-Smale. And then all people know that it is Morse-Smale system exactly after this paper. Morse-Smale system, Morse-Smale system. But this paper concerning to prove of inequality. But indeed, this paper contain two conjectures. What conjecture? Conjecture was concerning.
Does Smale know about Andronov-Pontryagin's work?
No.
He did.
Of course. Yet he know. He very good know because he writes that it is. I introduce this class after Andronov-Pontryagin paper. He knows. He very good knows that there is such paper. But after this paper. All world called that it is a Morse-Smale system, not Andronov-Pontryagin. Well, it does not matter, it's good object, and then we are happy. And then, what he suggests? He suggests, he supposes and conjecture that it's true theorem one. It means that all such system, or such system is rough if and only if is Andronov-Pontryagin in any dimension. And then this proof is dense, are dense in space of all flows. It was conjecture A. This was conjecture B in that paper. But we know that both this conjecture are not true. And Smale, in the same year, write paper about Hoss-Schön, et cetera. But this paper contains this conjecture. It's not true, indeed, not true. But he wanted to prove this. But fortunately, it's not true. And we know that our dynamical world is very rich. Not Morse-Smale is structural stable. Yes, in the same year, indeed. He proves that he's not right. He is not right. Mm-hmm. And then, what's happened after that? After that, very soon, all people start to consider discrete dynamical system with the same property. For example, if you consider diffeomorphism on the surface, Morse-Smale diffeomorphism. No, I don't need new definition because definition absolutely the same. Non-wandering set is finite hyperbolic, intersection of stable and unstable, transversal, transversal. And it will be Morse-Smale diffeomorphism. On the circle, Meyer proved complete classification, did complete classification. And what about surfaces? About surfaces, what we see? First problem for classification is the following. Because we admit transversal intersection, then we can get such situation. This situation has name heteroclinic points. It means that if you have one saddle points, other saddle points, the stable manifold intersect unstable manifold transversally, then we get Morse-Smale diffeomorphism has no gamma-clinic points. It's okay, it's fortunately, but heteroclinic, it's possible, of course. Moreover, if we see that, if you consider two nearest saddle points, then here we will see finite number orbits of heteroclinic points. But if we consider chain of saddle points more than two saddle points, then we see that here finite number orbits. But this separatrice goes to this, if you know by lambda lemma, and then we see infinitely many heteroclinic orbits. And then it was very good, very bad situation because we have to preserve all these heteroclinic orbits and we have to describe such situation by some invariant, maybe combinatorial, maybe topological invariant, I don't know. But it was very, very strong problem. And then people start from gradient-like diffeomorphism. If we have gradient-like, it means that there is no heteroclinic points. There is no heteroclinic points. If we have no heteroclinic points, then our diffeomorphism is very similar to flow. Very similar to flow. And then what we know? We know that our situation is absolutely the same. We see system like to flow. We can assign directed graph. We can assign three-colored graph and other things what you want. But unique difference from flow consists of that our point has some period. But there is no problem because if we assign some graph, for example, directed graph for this diffeomorphism, for example, our point can be period of two, and it means that we have substitution of the graph, and then we need that there is isomorphism of graph preserving this substitution. That's all. It's very good invariant, but only for gradient-like diffeomorphism. It's the same. And it was done from 81, my teacher, Greenis. Вячеслав Гринис with his pupil. Безденежных, I don't read, you will see in the slide if I have a time, if I will have a time. And then, what after that? After that, if we consider more complicated situation, it means that we add some heteroclinic points, and firstly we add heteroclinic points so named Bech 1, it means that finite number heteroclinic points, it means that chain of saddle point not more than two, contains more, not more than two saddle. And then, for example, the simplest situation is such. If we have alpha here, omega 1, omega 2, saddle 1, and then here we have some intersection, omega 3, for example, this. And then, what is the invariant for this case? This invariant also was achieved by Grinis in 1993, and then this invariant also combinatorial invariant, because what we can do for this system? We can delete all separatrices, almost all, but remains separatrices which take part on intersection, in intersection. Then we get some cells, and we assign for this system some graph, directed graph, vertex, etc. But one vertex corresponds to some heteroclinic intersection. It means that this edge goes to heteroclinic, one vertex devoted to heteroclinic domain. And then in this heteroclinic domain, we assign some signature. For example, we can describe such intersection between two nearest saddle point by some substitution. We can enumerate numbering this point intersection along one separatrice, but after that along other separatrice, and then we get some substitution. 1, 2, 3, 4, for example, 3, 2, 1, 4. No, for example, I don't know, I did not need to check. And then it was combinatorial, very combinatorial invariant, but after that it was stopped because it's impossible to describe signature for Bech more than one, because we know that nearest saddle points has such signature, next has other signature, but what signature between first and third saddle point? It was very big question. And then we try to solve this problem in this year, indeed. We did not finish, we almost finished this paper with Sebastian Van Strien, also Slava Grinis, it's my advisor, and me. And what we suggested, this idea goes from Remy Langevin, if you know Remy Langevin. And then what they suggest, or he suggested, for example, if we consider very initial our situation and sink points here, then we can assign combinatorial graph, but we know that it's not exit for Bech more than one. But what we can do in this case, for example, instead all combinatorial consideration, we can consider basin of each sink. And what we know, in this basin, our point is hyperbolic. It means that it's topologically conjugated to linear contraction. If it's linear contraction, then here there is disk, two-dimensional disk, which goes to interior, to its interior. And then we get some annulus here, annulus. And then if you consider this domain, basin of this sink, it means that stable manifold of omega, maybe such, without omega. And if you consider space of orbit here, space of orbit, and what we see? We see that this space of orbit is torus, is usual torus. It is usual torus, like this. And then after that, we can see each separatrice who goes to this basin, like like circle, indeed, like circle. Each separatrice has to be circle in this torus. It means that we see such description of this dynamics. We see basin of synced torus, we see such separatrices of torus. Moreover, for example, if our saddle point has period, for example, 2 or any other period, then we will see here. But if this separatrice has period n, it means that this circle has n rotation along this meridian. It means that, no, like this. Then there is this. From this consideration follows immediately that all separatrices for gradient like has the same period. No, for example, because on the torus there is no disjoint curve with different rotation. And then it was suggested by Remil and Jivén, and then he considered this situation. For gradient like, it's good invariant indeed. If you consider all this torus, all this knot on this torus, we know about our system. But he is afraid, then we start to go to Bech 1. If we consider this system, for example, then what we see on our torus? On our torus, we will see also near this thing, we see good situation and torus with some circle, that's all. But if you consider this sync point, then we see torus here also. We see one good circle, you see here, for example. And on the other torus, we see also one good circle. But what we see when we project to this manifold this unstable separatrices, what we project, we see that this separatrices is not connected because we have to delete these heteroclinic points in our consideration, in our basin, there is no. And then we see such loop, non-compact loop, which accumulated to the circles. Rotate. And other part of this loop will be here, for example. It's rotate. And then Langevin stopped here. And because we don't know how we have to connect these two part of this curve. But if you consider next Bech, it means that what we see here, we see that first level saddle points is compact circle, but after that finite number pieces of accumulated to this, but after that infinitely many pieces accumulated to previous level, etc. It's very difficult situation, and then stop here. But indeed, we exactly use this invariant. But it's not so difficult to see such picture. Why? Of course, it's not compact. It's not a very wild behavior accumulated to the circle. But indeed, if we consider neighborhood of the circle, first level, then we see that it's very compact. Because one arc out of this neighborhood and one arc here on this neighborhood. And then we assign paired point, what you want, then connected to separatrices. And the same for these separatrices. If we choose neighborhood of next level curve, then we see that this curve also will be compact. Then we find some neighborhood in some sense, but unfortunately, this invariant depends on choosing of neighborhood. But if we choose in some sense maximal neighborhood, then we will see signature for arbitrary Bech. And then we do this, and now we are ready to publish this paper. A few days we start to publish. But if it's possible, I can show a little bit, only photo that you remember some people from Nizhny Novgorod, not from Nizhny Novgorod, and maybe, yes, I have 4 minutes, yes, it's okay. I have to say that complete topological classification for any diffeomorphism with axiom R on the surface was got by Bonatti and Langevin also, yes, but complete classification. But in some sense, we suggest other approach to this. And then you see, it's my co-author. Как тут надо листать-то? Ага, вот Андронов. I show this photo, if you're not against. Александр Александрович Андронов, he created school on dynamical system in Nizhny Novgorod. And then this school, there is, fortunately. Лев Семенович Пантрягин was blinded. If you see Moscow mathematician. And then hyperbolic you don't need, serial connection you don't need, I think. Леонтович Андронова, wife of Андронов. Евгений Санна Леонтович Андронова. Майер, Артемий Григорьевич Майер. Colleagues in my university, we studied all portraits of these people, lives on the wall. Non-closed recurrent trajectory you don't need. This is classification with Meyer, you see. This is the change orientation and preserving orientation. Maurizio Peixoto from Brazil, you know. And then Smale, Steve Smale. I think that all people also know Steve Smale. Mm-hmm. And then this is Horseshoe, this is Pelis. Together with Smale, they proved that Morse-Smale diffeomorphism are structural stable indeed. It's not dense, but to prove that it's structural stable, it's also was problem. Directed graph by Peixoto, for example, for diffeomorphism. On this picture, both graphs are isomorphic, but systems are not topologically equivalent. That's example from Peixoto paper. This is Ashemkov Sharko, we see Ashemkov, Andrei Ashemkov, and Vladimir Sharko, and you see that different behavior on these cells. After that, three-colored graph, but we see, for example, for that, such system, it's directed graph, it's three-colored graph. For example, if we see difference between of them. This is heteroclinic point. Green is безденежных, I have no photo. And then this is signature. You see, we can describe this by substitution. It's invariant for Bech-1. For example, we can see as compact curve Bech-1. It's also possible to describe by topological invariant. And we did this with my colleagues Tatiana Mitrikova. And then Bonatti Langevin. Bonatti Langevin, if I said that Bonatti and Langevin did complete classification for arbitrary axiom R diffeomorphism on the surfaces, but due to Markov partition, but they did not select Morse-Smale diffeomorphism in distinct class. And then it's not very convenient because it seems for me that our invariant is more clear